The next thing we will create is the cluster shifting. For this, we will first again clean our mesh up, because if we distort our mesh, we can now see that we don't have an even distribution of polygons. For this, let's convert into a VDB. VDB convert back to polygons, and then we will use array. The collision primitives will be the original surface, and now we can say the resolution should be again the same as this one. And the ray should be set to minimum distance to snap to the closest point on this geometry to get more details back. Now if we distort and look at the polygons, we will have an even distribution. Now let's create some new normals, because after converting to VDB, we now have no more attributes. Point normal. And now we will create a cluster. This cluster will divide our geometry into different pieces based on attributes we put in. We will need position and normal. Now let's visualize this cluster, and we can see this is roughly in one direction, this and this. Now here we have some really small values. For this we will use a attribute blur and blur our normal, because if we blur this, can now see that small disturbances in the base shape won't affect our clustering. So we could now affect how strong the normal affects this division or the position. So when we increase the position, now it's not only based on the normal, but more how far the points are. Put back position to something like 3 and this to 8. We don't need so much iterations, and set the amount of clusters. So when we just have 3, now we would have those 3. Let's put it to 8 for now. We will control later this, this, and this. So now this cluster attribute is on the points. Now let's promote these attributes from points to primitives, cluster, and we will not only use the average, because if we now look at the clusters, for example at this position, you can see we have the intersection line. The reason for this is because, let's just say, this cluster right here is the cluster number 3, for example, and this is cluster number 5, then if we promote this point right in the middle, it will be the average of those two. So between 3 and 5 will be 4, so we'll create a new cluster basically. So let's just always use the minimum. So in this case, it would just use 3, for example. We don't want to delete the original, So, let's keep it on the points. And now we can vertex split our geometry based on our clusters. So we have separate shells. For this, let's use the attribute cluster type primitive. And now we could select those different shells and move them out, for example. Now they are not connected anymore. So what this does is just looks at a point or primitive and its neighbors, and if they are different, then it splits. Now, because we separated our shells, we can easily find all the borders before it would be really hard. So now we can just use a group, set this to points and call it something like border. And now we can just group our unshared edges, so our borders. Nice, now we just grouped all of them. Let's fuse them together. So now we cannot select them separately anymore. It will be one mesh, but the group will still remain. In this case, we still have nearly 2000 points in the border group. Now we will group expand those. So let's select our border group and write it to our border group. So this will the name of the new group name, and just increase it by one. So in one in every direction. So more feature we want to add is to calculate how large these areas are for each cluster. For example, here this will be one cluster, but we don't actually want something like this to act like a cluster. So let's create a measure and measure the area to later mask them out. Measure and set the attribute to the points. Measure the area. We wanted not to measure each point separately, but for each piece. And the piece will be cluster. So now it goes through this cluster, deletes everything. So, for example, blasts away every point with the cluster number 0. For example, this one. Now it measures the whole area, and then it will add this area to each of the points as an attribute. Now go through all the clusters, 1, 2, 3, and so on. We can set this area now directly in the measures up to 0 and 1. Just bake the visual range and set it to 0 and 1. We created our own tool because we wanted to blur it afterwards and then convert it to 0 and 1. And now we will add a system to shift out each of our clusters based on a probability. For this, let's create a attribute wop. Call this cluster shift.